This is pretty much the three betting ranges we're looking at. Again, unlike a No Limit Hold'em, you don't ever want to get in there three betting with just two random cards as kind of a three betting light concept. Three betting light is not a concept in Limit Hold'em. Your three bet range has to be pretty well defined, and you would never just throw in 7-4 just for the sake of doing it. That's only going to cost you money, again, because it's too hard to win a pot in Limit Hold'em without a showdown. Of course, you can do it sometimes, but it's not nearly often enough to make something like 7-4 a valuable 3-bet. So take a look at this. Again, it's not important you memorize it exactly, but it is important that you have kind of a feel for it, so that in a 6-max game, if the cutoff opens and you're in the button and you look down at A7, what do you do? Well, you should know that that's right about in the range where you could be 3-betting. Whereas if you look down at King-8 in the same situation, you should know that that's definitely on the loose side, and most good players would not 3-bet a cutoff raise from the button with King-8. And really not King-9 either, but that's a little closer, especially if you're suited to the borderlines I'm suggesting here. So get a feel for these ranges. These ranges are going to come into play a lot as we try to analyze hands going forward. Because anytime we construct a strategy, we're going to have to know what our range was going in, and that all goes back to pre-flop, which is a point I tried to hammer home in the last video. All right, so we are the last aggressor pre-flop. We are the attacker. When do we continuation bet? Well, as a 3-better, because we have such a strong range, as I just got finished discussing, there's not any flop where you would 3-bet pre-flop and then check the flop. You're 100% continuation betting every board if you have a 3-bet range pre-flop. Similar to, as I was discussing before, if you are an earlier position raiser, hijacker earlier, your opening range is so tight, relatively speaking, that if no one has 3-bet you, if you have remained the aggressor, then your range is going to be so much stronger than theirs that you can and should continuation bet 100% of the time. As I started discussing in an earlier slide, it's only at the later positions where you might not continuation bet every time. And this is similar to, again, if you're on the small blind and you've opened, you have a tighter range than most people might think, but you're still opening kind of a lot of hands. I think I said 37%. So that's another range where, even though your range is significantly better, it should be anyway, than the big blind's defending range, the out of position aspect of it changes things slightly. You might find some flops to try to get to showdown faster and see if you can go check a few times. This is mostly applying to heads up. In a multi-way pot, the rules are generally the same if you get two callers, although you can find a few more checkbacks with the showdown parts of your range if you get two callers, especially if you've opened from the hijack, the cutoff, or the button. If you've opened from early and you get a button caller and a big blind, and by the way, you should never cold call yourself in Limit Hold'em. That's almost a hard and fast kind of rule. Pre-flop, if there's been a raise in front of you, you're almost always playing 3-bet or full. The only real exception to this is if there has been at least one cold caller and preferably two by the time it gets to you. And if you're playing in a tough game, that just does not happen. So you're not going to find yourself cold calling raises too often in Limit Hold'em. So we're kind of just going to avoid even talking about that. But if you're playing against opponents who do play this way, say you've raised an early position and the button calls and the big blind calls, you're still continuation betting 100% of flops. You still have enough equity in your range versus those two ranges on basically any flop that you should, and I think actually every flop, you should still be continuation betting 100% of the time. If you get three callers, and again, this does not happen in tough games, but I'll just go over it quickly. If you get three callers, now you can find some flops to check back that are neither bluffs nor value bets, simply because you don't want to just be throwing money away by firing aimlessly, and you can even shut down on some potential bluffs too. But mostly what we're discussing here though is heads up, and so the guidelines for checking back on heads up are, as I've discussed, your position, just basically comparing your range to your opponent's and seeing how much stronger is my range than the defender's range. And we'll again talk more about the defender's range in the next video, but for now you should just know that if you've opened and they have not 3-bet you, and you were in an early seat, you have a much stronger range than theirs. And even though a big blind defending without 3-betting could have a really strong hand in Limit Hold'em, they could also have so many other hands that your opening range from the hijacker earlier is just going to crush them.